لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل وعلا نستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون أول بلا ابتداء دائم بلا انتهاء لا يفنى ولا يبيد ولا يكون إلا ما يريد لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام ولا يشبه الأنام حي لا يموت قيوم لا ينام وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وقرة أعيننا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وسلم أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وعبد الله ربه حتى أتاه اليقين صل اللهم وسلم وبارك وجدد وضاعف وعظم ومجد على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وارض اللهم عن أزواجه وذرياته وأحبابه وأصحابه وأتباعه والتابعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله أحثكم وإياها على طاعته واستفتح بالذي هو خير أما بعد يقول مولانا عز وجل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وتفقد الطير فقال ما لي لا أرى الهدهد أم كان من الغائبين لأعذبنه عذابا شديدا أو لأذبحنه أو ليأتيني بسلطان مبين فمكث غير بعيد فقال الآيات طبعا are in سورة النمل الله عز وجل is describing to us a scene that was in سورة النمل between سليمان عليه الصلاة والسلام وبتوين الهدهد or the hoopy First, Sulaiman, طبعاً, لأن سليمان عليه الصلاة والسلام, he was a king and a prophet, both. Some prophets were not kings. يعني they were not the political leaders in a king way of their communities. They were just the prophets of their communities. Some were, no, they were kings. Allah عز وجل made them also, gave them that. وسيدنا سليمان عليه الصلاة والسلام was a leader who he did as Al-Quran Al-Kareem says, tafaqqad. Tafaqqad, a leader always checks on those he entrusts with tasks. Not because he distrusts them, but because it's the job of the leader to follow through and follow up. And alhamdulillah, we always fail when we don't do that. We give somebody something and we say, we're supposed to do it. Come after 1 year, he didn't do anything. After 2 years, he didn't do anything. After 3 years, he starts killing you for asking him, why did you not do? Lakin the sunnah is not this way. Well, no, you know, shaitan is crafty. وَتَفَقَّدَ الطَّيْرِ فَسُلَيْمَانْ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ is teaching us accountability. Accountability, that's what it is. كلكم الحديث, as you all know, كلكم راع, all of you are responsible. Everyone is responsible for whatever Allah has accounted him with. That's part of responsibilities. So one should, number one, those who are leaders, lessons for me first, and for all of us who are in leadership position, is now it's good to trust people. Even having treacherous people doesn't, should never change you to trust people. Evil acts should not change noble nature. Otherwise, evil wins. Doesn't work that way. But then you're supposed to what? Follow up and follow through and have milestones to see if these are met or not. طيب. And that's what Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam is teaching us. Al-Quran طبعاً, has no business in a sense telling us a story without lessons. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ. Ooh, عِبْرَةٌ is lesson learned. Ooh, what is history anyway? Ola, what is all these things? Except that lessons, it's like a lab. When today you go to medicine, they have reference values, right? If you get a CB, you get a blood check, let's say, you get values. And what do they compare them to? Reference values. Ooh, if you are below or above, right? High or low. Oh, that's what exactly Al-Quran Kareem is giving us with the stories of the nations before us. These are lab values. Check yourself whether you are less or are you going to excess each ways. Because you're not going to be bid'an min ar-rusul. You're not going to be different from the rest of the world or of the nations. What will happen to them if you do the same thing will happen to you. Doesn't Einstein, doesn't he say that it's crazy to do the same thing over and expect different results? Why? إذن a job of a leader is accountability. وتفقد الطير فقال ما لي لا أرى الهدهد. Where is the hoopy? طبعا now let's leave it like this. Some people think الهدهد is different things. لكن let's just leave it right now. Where is the hoopy? Where is this one? Assistance. It seems that Allah عز وجل enabled سليمان عليه الصلاة والسلام of not only communicating with other than human beings but also commanding them. Now notice the Prophet ﷺ in general communicated with other than human beings. يعني you see نبينا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وذرياته وأزواجه وسلم. You know what he that the tree was weeping as in صحيح البخاري. It came and there was communication. You know the hadith في صحيح مسلم where النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he says إني there used to be a hajar. There was a hajar. كان يسلم علي بمكة. Used that stone used to give me salam every time I pass by the stone in مكة. يعني this now in مكة, not in مدينة. Remember, way early. يعني that stone would say السلام عليك يا رسول الله. He says إني لأعرفه الآن. I still know that stone. يعني the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام Allah equips الأنبياء عليهم السلام to be able to communicate with all levels of existence, whether it's ملائكة because they have communication with the وحي, so they are on that نوراني level because the ملائكة are from نور, whether it is on the level of human beings, whether to communicate with the jinn, whether to communicate with the animals, with the plants, etc. وطبعا فيها نكتة يعني this is there's a point here. If المصطفى الأعظم صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم is telling us that إني لأعرفه الآن about a حجر, about a stone that gave salam to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم still keeps that stone in his memory and says I still know that stone. Imagine someone whose heart is filled with the love of Allah and his Rasul and he sends his السلام to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله. الحديث اللي رواه ابن ماجه و others etc. right? That anyone that gives that sends their salam to me إلا رد الله علي روحي. Allah gives me my soul. I send that salam back. If the حجر is remembered, the بشر is more prioritized. صلى الله عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. Now today among the things that we have also is that al-futur or the debilitation fi mahabbati Allah azza wa jalla wa mahabbat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We make it, and what do you mean you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What's wrong with you? وتعال انت look at the صحابة, شوف الصحابة رضي الله عنهم, look at عروة بن مسعود الثقفي في صحيح البخاري when he goes as an appointee of Quraysh to communicate and negotiate a deal with the Muslims, how he describes the صحابة رضي الله عنهم. He went back. طبعا عروة بن مسعود شخصية فذة وشخصية international, يعني دولي, he is not just a local person, well traveled. He says about himself that number one, he was the leader of Thaqif. Number two, he used to go to Kisra, the king of Rome, the kings of Persia, and the kings of Rome, and the king of Rome. He used to sit in royal courts. And you know what it is? It's not about anything, but those who sit in royal courts and they go to big people in the world today, they there's etiquettes, there's protocol. They see different levels of people. No, because kings or presidents or etc., they always try to bring all different levels, the best levels of their social, of society, they bring them to them. One who knows religion, one who knows philosophy, one who knows economics, one who knows politics, one who knows. For being in that, obviously, he's well traveled, Yani, today. That's why Quraysh picked him. He tells them when he goes back, Hadith al-Bukhari, I don't want to spend time talking about it today. He goes back, he says, Yaqum, there's no way you can fight this man. This man, ليس لكم قبل. You have no power to fight this man. Why? They tell him, what are you talking about? He says, I traveled to the kings of Rome and the kings of Persia. I have never seen people glorify their man like the companions of Muhammad glorify Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. If he makes wudu, they fight over the remainder of his wudu. One covers his face with it, one covers his hands with it, one does. This was the affinity that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in had to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why would someone fight over something that touched the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why today is where the weakness and the thing, because we've taken religion as philosophy, no more theology or no more religion. Philosophy, we talk about the religion. That's what philosophy does. Like in religion, experiences faith. There's difference. فالأنبياء used to talk to things, other things, they speak to them. They communicate with them, even if they are not accountable, like stones are not accountable, shajar is not accountable, hajar, trees are not accountable. Lakin, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is rahma not lil bashar only, but rahma lil alameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So you see that recipient, the recipient on the other side of the unconditional prophetic mercy, also interacting with it. We've talked about that. Anyway, Sayyidina Sulaiman seems to have command over the wind, as the Quran speaks. سَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحِ. The winds are at his command, not just order, not just speak to it. He orders it to do things. It seems that al-jinn were also part of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam sessions or majalis. It seems طبعاً human beings are also part of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam's majlis. Animals as well. If the hudhud here means the hoopy, obviously, then he was also involved. Yani very diverse, reflecting the creation. Everything is there. When the man or the hudhud or the hoopy was missing, the next ayah goes to say, Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam says, لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. I am gonna hold him to severe punishment. أو لأذبحنه, or I will have him killed. Where is he missing on his duty? أو ليأتيني, or he should come with a real good excuse. He's got to have a real good thing. What have you been doing? Where have you been missing? What are you doing? Oh, today maybe this call is for the ummah. يعني الأمة اليوم في سبات. We used to say, they used to teach us in the old days when we were children, من طلب العلا سهر الليالي. Today, من طلب العلا شخر الليالي. Whoever wants to seek the heights, he sleeps. Between سهر and شخر is only little things, couple of dots. Sahir means he stays up the night seeking them. How can you sleep and you haven't accomplished your task? What are you doing? Now today we change that into go sleep at night, and tomorrow inshallah we will figure things out. Until you figure things out, what do you mean figure things out? Why don't you get things done? Well, that's the message we take from Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. When will you procrastinate today's job till tomorrow, and tomorrow till the day after, and the day after, the day after? When will ever things be? Why do you think Al-Quran al-Kareem gave us the salah in these five different times? As Al-Hajj is in a specific time, as Siyam it is a specific month. All these things, they have times. It's the time management of the believer, and that's why one of the most important things Allah gave us after Iman is Al-Waqt. Time or time management. One of our shaykh, Sheikh Fattah Abu Ghudda rahimahullah, used to say, وَالْوَقْتُ أَثْمَنُ مَا عُنِيتَ بِحِفْظِهِ وَأَرَاهُ أَسْهَلُ مَا عَلَيْكَ يَضِيعُ. The waqt is the most valuable thing Allah gave you as a human being. The limited breath you have, but it's the easiest thing that you spend. The cheapest thing you spend is time. Everything can come back. Time cannot come back. Health can come back. Money can, wealth can come back. لَكِنْ وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي Done. And there's no way. Khusr, you're always at loss when it comes to asr, yani time. When it comes to time, there's no winning time. Time is only going down. There's only one way, there's no other way. Allah Azza wa Jal may put barakah in time. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to put barakah in time. Barakallahu feek. فَمَكَثَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ هَذَا الْدُهُوبِ. Now it seems that he realized, though he was in charge of the reconnaissance missions, it seems like, yani he's the chief reconnaissance officer of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, if there's such a thing, or I used to call him General Hudhud. Oh, everybody is a general today. So call them general. Everybody has a title, why not the Hoopi? And if you don't have a title, you make one up. La ilaha illallah. You know, studying 2 years, 3 years becomes, it goes from CD to Ustadh to Sheikh. Well, the titles grow then. The only one. And I have taken this hadith from this grand Sheikh. What did you do with this hadith, ya Habibi? Did it transform you, or you're just telling me that you've taken from this and you've taken from that? I'm very impressed by what you've taken. But how did that make you Muhammadi in character? How did that make you Rabbani? Allah says, وَلَكِنْ كُونُوا وَلَا تُزَكُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't praise yourself. Take it easy. لَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. You took or you didn't take. Who cares? What have you done with your life? لكن we are in the age of talking more than, as Ibn Mas'ud says, more than doing. Doing becomes unannounced, unmarketed. Talking is the marketed one. And if you can market the talk, it becomes much better than the walk. Because you sell them that delusion of talking. كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيَعَ يَحْسَبُهُ أي والله يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمَانُ مَاءً. It's false delusion that you see. You'll come to it at the end, you'll see. نعم. هذا الهدهد, this whoopee, he says, قال أَحَطُّ بِمَا. He came back to Sulaiman عليه الصلاة والسلام. Where have you been? So he's already ready with an answer. قَالَ أَحَطُّ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ وَجِئْتُكَ مِنْ سَبَئٍ بِنَبَئٍ يَقِينٍ. Immediately, it seems, the Quran puts it as the Hoopi himself started Sayyidina Sulaiman to talk. He did not wait for him to say, where have you been? Huh? Also adab. Unta adab is, all right, you've been absent. Give me a report. No, I have to beg you 15 million days about a report and you don't want to do anything. Even when you give the report, you make a whatever. But he comes and he says, "Hattu bima, I have knowledge of things that you don't know." Whoa, not so you're still small hoopy. You're talking about Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. Yani we just said that the winds, Allah put it at his command. The jinn are sitting there, the ins are sitting there, the animals, you're small hoopy, you know more than Nabiullah Sulaiman. He tells him very confidently. It seems that he was a very confident reconnaissance officer. He says, أحط بما لم تحط به. I know that which you don't know. Not only that, وجئتُكَ مِنْ The proof is, what is the proof? Tell me right away. Don't tell me you know what I don't know. Tell me the actual proof. Don't give me just stories of what you know. Who cares about what you know? It's also teaching us how, I know this, or I learned this, or I took this, or I learned this hadith, or I took from this sheikh, or I took, at the end of the day, and you see it. قَالَ أَحَطُّ بِمَا لَمْ تُحَطْ بِهِ وَجِئْتُكَ مِنْ سَبَئٍ بِنَبَأٍ I came to you from long, far away. So the reason I was, number one, without telling him the reason I was absent for a while, he told him why. I came from Sabah, long place, far place. So you know, I don't, لَنُّ اللَّبِي بِنْ إِشَارَةِ يَفْهَمُ The smart person that you don't need to spell out. Unpack العبارة. من الإشارة من لم ينفعك لحظه لن ينفعك لفظه. If you don't understand from the sign, you will never understand the whole book. He says, I came from Sabah. Sabah, far from Palestine, where Sayyidina Sulaiman was. Already answers why it took me a while. Huh? وَجِئْتُكَ مِنْ سَبَأٍ بِنَبَأٍ يَقِينٍ The reason I'm telling you, I know that which you don't know, I have something that's yaqeen. Yaqeen now, this is not he said, she said, they said, somebody said, I feel, I think. He says, not only I know, but that know that naba is actually yaqeen, absolutely verifiable in all parts by him saying, أَحَطُّ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ He did not say, أُخْبِرْتُ I was told. I have now made a comprehensive case from all aspects, and I know all aspects of what I'm telling you now. أَحَطُّ إِحَاطَ means I have surrounding knowledge of it. It's not just a claim, right? Today, yesterday. طيب, what is this نبأ يقين? نبأ يقين, يقين means certain. It's not just I have comprehensive, it's verifiable, it's all these things from all, and I have comprehensive, certain news. إني وجدت امرأة تملكهم. He says, what is the news? The hoopy says, I found people who are governed by a woman. Even the hoopy is wondering. Ajib. Maybe istihjan as well. Hatta the hoopy is thinking that a woman is leading them. Huh? The first thing he says, إني وجدت امرأة. I found a woman. What is this woman? She governs them. وَأُوْتِيَتْ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ And she has something from everything. وَلَهَا عَرْشٌ عَظِيمٌ And her arsh is عظيم. This is context. Context in the old days, Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, thousands of years ago, before Islam, women could not be in any position. They were prohibited from even being taking the highest levels in religious institutions. Forget the social or political or economic. Religious, someone who wants to be devoted to Allah. No, if you're a woman, you can't be devoted. In fact, they were possessions, as you all know. Now, we all know, up until the 16th century, today we are in the 21st, 16th is not that far, huh? The conversation or the dialogue in Europe that was happening between Acidalius and Gedicus about is women a human or not? This is 16th century. She human or not? And not only that, obviously, the dialogue amongst many theologians, whether she had a soul or women do not have a soul. يعني is she instinctive only, غرائزية only, it's just, or is she actually has a ruh, there's a soul in her actually. That was issues, and you all know, I mean, amongst the people, Aristotle who said, no soul, no mind. Not only no soul, no mind even. Huh? Among the people who are also attributed to having saying Aquinas, Thomas Aquinas in the 11th century, He says also, irrational, no reason, no soul. Can't, he says, no reason. Recent. Reason, not that far. No reason. Lakin, why is the Hopi wondering? Not because of that. Before, that's how it was oftentimes. Lakin al-Islam came not to really do what was done before. Al-Islam first came and gave the right of being, number one, a human being, absolute. You're an absolute equal human being. Inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. All human beings, we made you from males and females immediately like this. We made you into males, we made you into females. Islam came and said accountability is the same in the sense of what? In the sense of if you pray two rak'ah fajr and a woman prays two rak'ah fajr, your prayer is not heavier than hers. If you give zakah $1, she gives zakah $1, your zakah as a male is not heavier than hers. You're both equal. Oh, أَنَا الْإِنسَانِ مَا سَعَى. And the human being has that which the human being earns. Islam came and gave the right of ta'lim, which was prohibited. It was prohibited for women to acquire knowledge. Don't teach her things. لكن بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان, the whole insan. هذا اللام إذا كانت لام الجنس أو لام العهد now. لكن this human insan, الله علمه البيان, the human insan, regardless whether male or female, علمه البيان. Well, that's why you see the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was to teach the males and female sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhunna il hadith li rawal khatib al-Baghdadi and others. The hadith is da'if, lakin the meaning is there. Al-ma'na sahih, yani corroborated al-ma'na. في الآيات والأحاديث طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم. The hadith came from 50 different routes, lakin it's da'if. Imam al-Suyuti says, I am the first who authenticated this hadith. Al-Suyuti came in 911 of Hijra. Now, before him, al-ulama did not authenticate al-hadith. Al-hadith غير صحيح. وَلَوْ تَعَدَّدَ الطُّرُقُ. طيب, anyway, lakin the meaning is there that you should seek knowledge. Right? اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ يعني oh human being, read. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم, علمه, علم الذكر, لا علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم, وعلم الإنسان, the whole إنسان. So that is another thing that Islam came. Islam came and gave financial independence. She can own and she has right in her own property. Al-Hupi is wondering why you're wondering you saw a woman owning. Because you are come from a context where women were actually sold as pieces of furniture or as possessions anyway. Up until recently, if you actually go and look at the history, up until the era of Reformation in Europe, the women were actually possessions of the father, then the husband, etc. Total possessions. La Islam came and said, you know what, if she has money and she gets married, she doesn't have to give money to her husband. The husband must spend money on her. He can't take her money, for example. If she earns money, it's her money, etc. She can inherit. All these things were not there. Not only التعليم, not also the political and social act, participation. يعني انت, you have in the authentic hadith where الصحابيات رضي الله عنهم, ليش, what do you think about the bay'ah is? In the bay'ah, weren't there female sahabis giving bay'ah to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Of course they were. Giving bay'ah means they were pledging support and loyalty, and that they would put themselves at harm before the da'wah and the message and the mission of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The women, actually women sahabiyat, actually pledged before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that they would actually, they were part of the pledge. Males and females. Sure, the protocol of bay'ah between males and females was different, but in essence, the female sahaba gave bay'ah as well to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to put themselves and everything they own and everything about them in the first, before the mission and before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, التعليم, not only التعلم, also look at Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, Ibn Khallikan and others. They mention, he says, they mention a narration through Masruq, other than, before Ibn Khallikan, so we can go, قبل. لكن he says لقد رأيت مشيخة أصحاب محمد. I have seen the senior صحابة of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ask عائشة رضي الله عنها on matters of fiqh. She became not only she became a teacher of all. That's why you see Ibn al-Jawzi al-Hafiz, who died 597 of Hijra, he mentions three female shuyukh of his. الإمام الحافظ بن الجوزي. You will see الحافظ المنذري رحمه الله mentions at least 15 female shuyukh of his. I'm talking about 1,000 years ago. I know sometimes. الحافظ بن حجر, الحافظ بن عساكر, etc., etc., etc. لا, الإسلام came and told not only you can learn, you can actually be the أستاذ, الأستاذية, the masterhood of a science. You're qualified. And therefore, يعني this issue of having women govern them was not a problem really to Muslims in general. طبعا Muslims, they look at the hadith of Abu Bakr, Abu Bakr رضي الله عنهما, Abu Bakr الثقفي, right? الحديث في صحيح البخاري. البخاري brought it twice في موضعين في صحيحه. والحديث says that Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه said, he says لقد نفعني الله بكلمة سمعتها من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أيام الجمل. He says I remembered something the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told me during the times of al-Jamal, later eventually that al-Jamal fitna that came later. He says but I remember a hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that helped me. وقد كدت أن ألحق بهم فأقاتل معهم, and I almost went with them, with the people of the Jamal, to fight with them. So they said, what did the Prophet ﷺ said that helped you like at that point? He said when he heard that the Persian al-Furs wallu ibnata Kisra alayhim, they put the daughter of Kisra as their king on them after her father died. He says لن يفلح قوم ولوا أمرهم امرأة, that people who make her in charge of their affairs will not be successful. He says, I remember that. I did not go to fight. I'm saved. طبعا الفقهاء المسلمين in general, they diversify the issue and they don't take it. It doesn't mean that some people go to say no. In the old days, they want to say, some of them want to say no, no, but a woman can never take any public positions. لا, you see Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, Ibn Hazm, others, they say no, she can take everything except being the Khalifa. And in the old days, Khalifa had to lead the people for Salah, or they had to lead the people for Hajj, or they had to lead the people, etc., and all these things. And the physiological needs does not facilitate necessarily. So they said, accept the Khilafah, the Ra'i ibn Hazm or ibn Jarir. Others, they said, no, other than that, she can be anything. Well, that's Ra'i al-Hanafiyya, for example, that the Hanafi scholars say, a woman can take any leadership positions for Qada, to be a judge even, except for Hudud al-Jinayat, except these two issues. She can take any leading position. That's early on. We're talking 1,400 years ago. And Muslims want to say she can be the judge, the supreme judge, except for al-qada, kada. Al-Malikiya, except for shahad, in the shahadat, she can take this, etc., etc. You see how fuqaha al-Muslimin, 1,000-some years ago, when people after 1,000 years were still discussing whether she's human or not, or she has a soul or not, were saying she can not only, she's already a teacher, she's already this, she's already that, she can also be a judge, she can take public positions. Umar radiallahu anhu put one of them, al-Hisba fil Medina, al-Shifa, her name, he put her in charge of the accountability on the streets of Medina and how people act in the streets and like the policing of Medina. Well, therefore, يعني, from this, Islam wanted to honor the human being that is a female and honor the human being that is a male and not turn the honor that Islam wanted to confer and not confer, to re-emphasize and reinstate actually to the woman, is not to objectify her, not to make her gharab, object. And when you make her an object, then it means what? Her values, how much she reveals of that object, for example. Oftentimes, today you see that, you see sometimes, not to ignorant people, not to knowledgeable people, even if they don't believe in anything. But they see, well, if you have a hijab, it means you're not as free. She swears 500 times if you want that she's free. No, I don't believe you. Oh, how? Well, you have this covering you. So then freedom to you is how much I reveal. Yani my value to you then, as a woman, is how much I reveal of that object called body. You're not looking at my thinking, you're not looking at my principles, you're not looking at my mission in life, at my sacrifice in life, at my principles. Isn't that what worth is? Sometimes we need to look at these things. Sometimes we need to look at these things. Allah al-Islam gave, went, all these things. Ooh. Women you see in Islam, everywhere, fil ulum, all kinds of things, participants in everything. The surprise of the Hopi should not be there. إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ مْرَأَةً تَمْلِكُهُمْ طَيِّبْ قَالَ وَأُوْتِيَتْ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. He says, أُوْتِيَتْ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ means she has something, she has everything. Who has everything? لكن هاي الكل طبعا, as you know, many of you know, عند الأصوليين هذه عام مخصوص. عام مخصوص means general but specified. Not every kul means everything. Min kulli shay doesn't mean that at that time the king, the queen of Saba, we'll talk next week, time has gotten us, we'll continue the ayah next week. Lakin, the queen had, utiyat min kulli shay, she had kul shay, everything. And she didn't have, for example, the moon with her. She didn't have the sun. She did not travel to next galaxy. Maybe she did not have a car, مثلا, for example. كل شيء عام مقمون. Why am I saying this? And oftentimes, today, في عصر this بدعة squad. Everything is بدعة. طب why, يا حبيبي, everything is بدعة. كل بدعة ضلالة. That means أنت take it easy. You have to corroborate the ahadith. That الحديث سيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها في صحيح مسلم, ما لم يكن عليه أمرنا, that which is not part of our deen. كل عام مخصوص, not every كل is everything. You say everybody is or as النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم for example said, كل مولود إلا, but there's استثناء, there's always exception. كل is not every, every is not always every, not in the Quran nor in the Sunnah. Maybe some other time we will talk about that. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه يغفر لكم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر. أشهد أن سيدنا محمدا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم الشفيع المشفع في المحشر. صلي اللهم عليه وعلى آله, أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر, وعلى من بآثاره مقتفى واهتدى واعتبر. عباد الله, اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه, راقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه. تزودوا من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضى. اعلموا أنه لا يضر وينفع, ويعطي ويمنع, ويصل ويقطع, ويخفض ويرفع إلا الله. واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه, قال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم, بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين, إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, أعلي يا مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه, من أراد بهم غير ذلك فاهده يا ربنا سواء السبيل، واكفنا شره وضره يا رب العالمين. اللهم آتي أنفسنا تقواها، زكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اشف اللهم مرضانا، عاف مبتلانا، فك أسرانا، ارحم موتانا. اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا مشايخنا من له حق علينا، لمن على الخير أعاننا، لمن عن الشر أبعدنا، لمن أوصانا بالدعاء. يا الله، everyone who came to this house of yours, blessed house of yours, in this blessed day of yours, in this blessed hour of yours, ya Allah, forgive all our sins, ya Rabbal Alameen, and everyone else, ya Allah. Ya Allah, everyone who has any need amongst us. Some people have difficulties, some people have challenges, some people have diseases, illnesses, ya Rabbal Alameen. Turn their diseases into eases, ya Allah. And turn their illness into healing, ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, our illnesses, our problems, turn them into ease, ya Rabbal Alameen. Forgive our sins, ya Allah. Guide us, for we need your guidance, ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, guide us, guide our mouth, and guide our hands, and guide our feet, and guide our minds to think the best, and guide our tongues to say the best, and guide our hands to do the best, and guide our feet to walk to the best, and guide our ears to hear the best, and guide our eyes to be the best, to be the best, ya Rabbal Alameen. Do not make us, ya Allah, separable even for a split second from your kindness and special care, ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, our parents and our grandparents and our great grandparents, ya Allah, forgive them and give them Jannatul Firdaus, ya Allah. Ya Allah, parole them with your rahmah, with the anbiya and the siddiqeen and the shuhada and the salihin, ya Allah. Ya Allah, accept them, ya Allah, in Jannatul Firdaus, ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen, keep our children and our grandchildren and great grandchildren, keep them on this path of Iman and in this path of Islam, ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, keep the light of Iman in their hearts, ya Rabbal Alameen, not just in their minds, in their hearts, ya Allah, and on their minds, and what they do and what they say, ya Rabbal Alameen. Keep them hadeen, mahdeen, guiding and guided, ya Allah. Merciful, merciful and mercied, ya Rabbal Alameen. And blessed, ya Allah, in this dunya and the akhirah. Keep, ya Rabbal Alameen, our progeny with Iman until the day of judgment, ya Rabbal Alameen. So that when we are assembled there, you are pleased with all of us, ya Allah. Make us among the best in this dunya and among the best in the akhirah, ya Rabbal Alameen. Fir lahumma lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minati al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka ya ربنا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله.